Good morning, students of class 10. You are welcome back to the e-classes now. Let's do our lesson in economics, sectors of the Indian economy. We are doing sectors of the Indian economy. Now we have reached how to create more employment. How more employment could be created. So let's talk about that. More are there. So there are 6 points over here I have written. There continues to be, listen carefully and pay attention. There continues to be considerable underemployment. Underemployment means disguised unemployment. Disguised unemployment in agriculture, where many people are employed, but the production doesn't increase. Instead of 2 people, 4 people are working. Where 2 people produce the same amount of food grains, and instead of 2, 4 people they are engaged, but the production doesn't increase. This kind of employment is called disguised unemployment, or you can say underemployment. They are not necessary, since they have nothing to do, they are engaged in the agricultural sector or in the field to support their family members. So they are not needed actually, but they work. They seem to work, but actually they are unemployed. So this type of underemployment continues to be considerable in agriculture. Now here, there are many who are not employed at all. In the rural areas, there are so many people underemployed, or some of them are not employed at all. They are unemployed. Many people you can find unemployed people. They do not have any jobs, they do not have any work. So, in what ways can one increase employment for people? Now, how can employment be generated for the people? So, to employment generate for the people, especially in the rural areas, near the cities there are factories, industries and so on. The rich people, they set up business or industries and this and that. But in the rural areas, people, most of the people are underemployed. They have nothing to do, so they are engaged in the activity, farming activity, along with their family members. So now, in what ways can one increase employment for the people now? The government, now here, the government should step in. Government should step in. The government can construct dams or construct canals to help farmers, as well as the people will get employment while constructing canals and constructing dams and canals. These projects, it will help the farmers, as well as this also generate employment for others also. More employment will be generated. There are various schemes and various steps government has taken to generate employment, to support the poor people in the villages. So there are many schemes the government has started. We'll talk about that later. Right now, if the government invests some money in transportation, if the government invests some money in transportation and storage of crops, cold storage of crops, or make better rural roads, if it is made better or motorable rural roads, they can provide employment to not just farmers, not only rural people, but other people who are in the service of transportation services and other business. This will also help the farmers, but also others who are in the services like transport or trade. So in this way, in the rural areas, employment can be generated, services can be generated, and that in this way the government has to step in. The government must invest in construction of canals, dams, better road connectivity to the cities, so that transportation can be done, So the goods from the villages or the crops, raw materials from villages could be transported to the cities, to industries, and in this way more employment could be generated. So another way by which this problem can be tackled or faced, the problem can be tackled in another way, is to identify, promote and locate industries, set up small industries, not big industries, rural areas. You can set up small oil mills, edible oil mills, flour mills and rice mills. You can start this industry, small industries or cold storage depots. So in this way, to identify the areas, promote and locate industries and services in semi-rural areas. Semi-rural means where population, large number of population is there. Semi-rural areas where many people may be employed in small mills, as I have told you, flour mills, saw mills, oil, edible oil mills, rice mills. There are many small mills. So people can be employed in these small mills, food processing units, food processing factories, or small food processing units can be set up by the government, where people, they get employment. It will help the farmers as well as other people will get employment. So in this way, more employment could be created or generated. There are other various steps also. So in this way, we can learn how to generate more employment. And in this way, especially the government should take the initiative and the government should step in to create more employment. So as far as the government is concerned, the government is doing its best. Their various state governments, the central government, they are doing their best to create employment as well as help the rural people, especially the poor people of the villages, to help them to generate more income, generate more employment. The government has stepped in and various schemes have been implemented. More policy makers also have made various policies so that people will get employment, as well as poor farmers, landless farmers, unemployed people, they get jobs and help from the government. So schemes have been made, and some of the schemes, many schemes have been implemented. We'll talk about that later. So right now, this much for today. Thank you very much for watching and paying attention to the class. So this much for today. Thank you very much. We'll meet in the next class and talk more about it. Thank you very much.